There is a light begins to fade
where the lost embers go. Ember ran, because standing still made them feel helpless. The wall glistened. The painting showed embers on a sacred journey. Ember felt so afraid and alone that it was a relief to find someone to talk to. Ember froze, almost too frightened to look away, when they noticed a small satchel. Felt heavy. Ember looked inside. The statue shone brightly in the light. Ember noticed something wrong. There was a round space where something used to fit. To Ember's delight, the golden statue slid perfectly into place. Ember left, feeling sorry for the stranger now alone in the dark. The stairway opened into a dark forest. Ember could feel fear taking over. They'd washed up alone, somewhere very unfamiliar. Ember felt like they were being watched. As Ember approached, the flame seemed to call out. With a feeling like falling, the forest fell away. Ember felt lost in darkness and ruin. The caged flame stoked new hope in Ember. Thank you. hope was almost within reach. The flame spoke and Ember listened. The flame lingered ahead. Was it trying to escape? Or leading the way? Fire flickered into life. The ghost spoke. Hope has returned to a forlorn. They will be safe here. I will warm them. Ember looked to the ghost for answers. This is a place between places, to travel through as your light fades. But none have passed in a long time. The Forest King holds us here, and those who dwell too long turn forlorn. Again, that word, forlorn. The forlorn are those who lost their way along the path. If you find them, send them to me and I will guide them. I am just a guide along the way to fan the flame. So many lost embers have I seen, more than I could help. Ember thought of those they loved, those they'd left behind. There are others lost along their journey. Find them and I will guide them. Whenever you feel ready, you may move on. A forlorn rests behind you, above this campfire. The stranger had been forgotten. They tried to guide the best they could. Thank you. The stranger looked at Ember somberly. I wonder who will meet us in the end. Barely visible through the murky water was the shadow of something hiding. And on a small pier, with barely a sound, a lonely fisherman sat. The stranger's courage lay dormant. They travelled paths long drowned. Solitude was all they knew. The forlorn resisted Ember's kindness. But still, Ember stayed. The stranger looked down. I took so much for granted. The stranger was trapped in their head. thought crowded in on them. The oldest fragment troubled them still. The stranger's voice was hoarse. It lingers, friend. It's hard to let go. The fisherman murmured quietly between soulful breaths. The gloom was choking. The fisherman felt so useless and alone. Sitting out there every day by the pond. Only the dark water to hear him talk. In that darkness, a glimmer flickered. A thought beating like a drum. A thought that went round and round. All started with a frog. Every day by the pond, a constant reminder. For a brief moment, the fisherman struggled to speak. The fisherman looked at Embo, hoping they would listen. The fisherman spoke softly. There's a frog in that pond, a big one. Saw him grow from a tadpole. We were friends of a sort. Spent every day side by side. So much better at fishing than me, that frog is. Catches them before I can bait them. Oh, it makes me feel useless some days. The fisherman sighed. I've wasted so much time feeling like this. Ember could see the old man struggling with their thoughts. Thanks for listening to me ramble on, Ember. You've got a good heart in there. If you need help catching anything, you just ask. Thanks for listening to me ramble on, Embo. You've got a good heart in there. If you need help catching anything, you just ask. The frog stared at Embo, its belly rumbling. Its eyes were fixed on Embo, but it seemed to mean no harm. Was this the frog that the fisherman spoke of? Embo could hardly ignore the rumbling from the frog's belly. The crow held its shining trophy tight. The worm looked helpless, with no way to escape. As Embo picked it up, the worm let out a little yelp. Inside was a scrap of journal. I am so scared. I've never been alone like this before. This is a place between places. It doesn't feel real to me. The Wanderer's Diary. On my lanthorn, playing a hollow tune to ward off the fear, a songbird took its perch beside me. The broken net hung ominously around the skeleton's neck. The stranger shivered in the cold. they'd moved through such dark places. Perhaps there was another way. The road had stolen all warmth. The stranger blinked at Ember. The two shared a moment of silence. The frog stared at Embo, its belly rumbling. This was not how Embo had imagined the end. The gurgling of water, a deafening heartbeat. But then, the fog returned Ember's good deed by leading them to a lost forlorn. The stranger was hoarding doubts. So much had been pushed away. They just wanted to rush on. But their way had trampled others. Even when their path was clear. In the end, they were alone. The stranger spoke hesitantly. It feels good to hear a voice other than my own. Ember found the Wanderer's diary. The frog in the forest knows more than they will say. I watch them carefully. I dare not go in the caves. The spiders whisper. The caves are deep. The fisherman noticed the broken net Ember was carrying. Let me have a look. See what I can do. With a silk thread, the fisherman carefully knotted it together. With each knot he tied, a net began to form. Here you go. Good as new. He was nestled between the reeds, but it was just out of reach. Ember used the net to catch the key. The old gate was locked. Ember placed the key in the lock and slowly began to turn it. The stranger asked Ember to leave them be. Sorrow was long buried. The stranger's thoughts dragged down. Tides ebb, washed over old walls. The stranger feared Ember's approach. Unsure what dark water could hide. The stranger spoke. Thank you for not turning away. Thank you for not turning away. The ghost said, "You have done all you can, little one. Your journey lies ahead. Little one, your journey ahead will not be easy. The path to leave this place is blocked. I will guide others to follow after you clear the way." Others like me who can help. You will always be welcome here in the forest. Once again, Ember could feel eyes watching. Ember uncovered a journal entry. The forest is misty after the morning rain, but there are pathways to find between the trees. Patches of sky through the canopy, rain-laden clouds above.